is part of our new series called Voices of a Nation that focuses on issues surrounding race, equity, and multiculturalism. Competitive video gaming, otherwise known as esports, considered one of the fastest growing sports in the world. But some believe there is a lack of diversity. St. Mary's University launched their Rattler Esports program this year. But as the Night Team's Stephen Cavazos explains, they hope to create more inclusion for Black and Hispanic students.
Regardless of skill level, you're still welcome.
Teresa Lee says it's a place for anyone and everyone. The senior is part of the Rattlers Esports program at St. Mary's University, which takes video gaming to a competitive level. Lee hopes she can serve as an inspiration to future gamers.
Being a African-American female in this community, I hope to be able to inspire those. If she can do it, I can do it too.
We're just here to have fun.
Jose Antelo is a student from Bolivia. He says the program has helped him feel included.
It's a sport that is growing very rapidly, and I wanted to be a part of this.
Head coach of the program, Caitlin Tenienta, says Black Americans and Latinos are often underrepresented in esports. She says that's because of accessibility issues, which are often associated with high costs of equipment and internet.
We recognize that that exists, and we want to make it a little bit easier for those who are not represented in esports.
The university hopes to bridge that gap by providing scholarships for future students of color.
The idea is that these scholarships would, in turn, help us recruit that kind of student to bring them into the program.
Tenienta says the scholarships are part of a bigger plan to create diversity and equity.
Esports is built on community. You're still getting something meaningful.
Stephen Cavazos, KSAT 12 News.
A fundraising event for those scholarships will be held tomorrow. It starts at noon and will be streamed live on the Rattlers Esports Program's Twitch feed. The goal is to raise at least $5,000. You can head to KSAT.com for more information.